You hold the weight of the world, still I don't slip through your hands. Your love is bigger than just a notion built by man. I fall again and again, but you whisper you're still mine. You feel the pain of the world, but you never push mine aside. And you reach for me with a love that quiets all my fears. And you reach for me like a father wipes away the tears. So many people in this world, but I hear you calling out my name. You reach for me. Now I'm never gonna be the same. There's nothing your eyes can't see. When I tried to give up, Lord, you never gave up on me. I give you all of my hopes and dreams, I lay them down. Of all the places I've looked, you're the one truth I have found. And you reach for me with a love that quiets all my fears. And you reach for me like a father wipes away the tears. So many people in this world, but I hear you calling out my name. And you reach for me. Now I'm never same. Never wanna be the same. Never gonna be the same.
So Monday was our first day of VBS, and what we do for that, we have all the kids come in, we'll feed them and maybe do a little game before, and then Nate will give a lesson. And what was really cool is just, they can't understand Nate at all, but just see how like intrigued and engaged they were, even though they had no idea what he was saying, was pretty awesome. And like just their eagerness to learn more about God's word and who he is really struck me and kind of convicted me, because we just kind of go through church just, you know, when we feel like it. Like if I feel like going to church today, but these kids are so eager to learn. They literally walk across a mountain to get here just to learn about.
I was really nervous about doing the vacation Bible school with the kids because the songs that we had were in English, and I was afraid that they wouldn't be able to really interact with us and that we wouldn't be able to engage them at all. But right before we decided to practice the music, we came up with a few lines of Creole and were able to come up with a Creole version of an English song and sing it with the kids. And it was really cool. In that moment, we were able to actually worship with the children and sing with them instead of just singing at them. And later, when I was out down by the marketplace, I heard some of the kids singing the song again, and it was just really cool because I know that it's something that we were able to bring them, that it's just something that the kids will be able to sing even after we're gone, and maybe they'll remember more about what we talked about during Vacation Bible School.
And then also on Sunday, we played soccer with the kids, which that was really cool because, I mean, we don't speak the same language, we come from totally different backgrounds, different lifestyles, but we still connect over something like a simple game like soccer. One thing that really God showed me through that was that even though we're totally different people, besides soccer, we're united through the fact that we're both Christians and we both worship the same Savior, and that we're both saved by this great God who loves us. And that's just, you know, the universal church. And so seeing that firsthand has really been big and been really eye-opening to me.
One thing that we did this trip was take a hike down to the water source.
And that was a really incredible experience because we got to see what the Haitians do several times a day. Walk down a really rough, rocky, slippery mountain just to get water for cooking and to bathe clothes. And it was just incredible to see how much they have to do just to get simple necessities like water when we so often find ourselves complaining about petty things. And it's just incredible to see that they have so much less than us material-wise, and they are so much happier with the things they have.
You know, through that whole experience, you realize that, you know, people have like a lot harder lives than, you know, I have back at home, and that it took me a second just to try to grasp, you know, how much I've been given, you know, from God and in America, and, you know, I can worship freely and I have all these things and I'm not grateful. I still complain about if the water's too hot or too cold, but these people have to walk, you know, 5K distance just to get water, you know, to live and for like their homes and for their families, and they do it every day. You see the little children carrying little jugs, or you see the adults carrying like 5-gallon buckets on their heads, and he's doing this incredible trek just because, you know, it's what they have to do to survive. But the thing is, I don't see these people complain about it. They're still grateful to God about everything they have, and they still, you know, go around smiling, and they'll tell you how extremely blessed they are and how great their God is, even though they have to walk, you know, 3 miles just to get water. And, you know, just God showed me that I really need to have a heart more of gratitude and just be so, I could just be so much more thankful about everything God's given me. And that was a really great experience.
One of the most enjoyable experiences I had here was doing the spa day for the cooks, and it really just took them by surprise because just me and a couple other girls got a bunch of buckets together and a bunch of the donated lotions and nail polish, and we just brought all the cooks into a room and we started off by washing their feet, and that really took them by surprise. Like, why would anybody want to touch my feet? And the look on their faces when we were done, just, they were so like amazed that we would do that. And I was kind of reminded of Mary in the Bible when she washed Jesus' feet. She didn't care what anybody thought. It was just what mattered to her most.
One thing that I really love doing here is, even though I'm completely exhausted at the end of the day, is coming to night church and watching everybody worship the Lord with all of their heart. And it's really inspiring because we'll go to church on Wednesday nights and think, well, I'm really tired because I've been to school all day and then I went and worked a couple hours and I don't want to stand up and worship. So I'll just sit and watch everybody else. But they've been working all day long in the hot sun and they still go and worship.
Coming into it, I didn't really know what to expect. Didn't know how differently they did worship, and if there was any difference, I thought it was maybe just more of a mellow worship. And to my surprise, came in the first night, and it was crazy to see how they do worship, because it's very different from how we do worship. It's very free, and it's really selfless, and it's really cool to be able to see how they don't. They're very, they don't care about what anyone else is doing around them or how they appear to other people, I guess. And just to be able to see them praise God in their own manner and in their own way. And I thought that was really cool to see, and it's really opened my eyes to how I worship and how I look and present myself to other people as I'm worshiping. So it's just made me more cautious of how I don't need to worry about what other people are looking, seeing me as I'm worshiping.
So I'm junior. I'm so excited to be there with American people. I like American people. When they come in Haiti, when they come in Chofar, what they bring their helps to the people in Chofar, to the pupils, to the students. That's very good. I love it. So I imagine something about people, American people. Just, I love God for that. Even though we got American people, we got Asian people, when we are Christian, we are one in Christ. God is faithful to me. God is good. I love God, and God that just make a relationship with American people and Asian people. Just I love American people, and I love the way that they are. I ask God to bless them. I ask God to protect them in their school, in their church, in the zone where they live. But I love God and I love the American people. Thank you so much.
I'm Cooper, and I absolutely loved Man Haiti, just like the scenery and playing football, well, soccer, as us Americans say it, and just meeting new people. And their culture is really different because you'll just see people, they're so resourceful, and it's just amazing how cool they are. And we actually have a church, a two-story building. It's a church and a school combined in, and the Haitians are just so happy to have all that. And you think it's just a building made out of plywood, when in Florida we have these huge mansions, but it's like everything to them.
The main goal is just to bring development around here. I mean, you know, some kids here, they don't have the chance to go to school, and the parents, you know, they are unable, I mean, to help them, and you know, minimum resources. And the main goal is to bring the gospel on here and help them to go to school, educate them.
Behind us you'll see an old horse stable, and this is where we first started out our school. We started with 30 kids, and now it's grown to over 300 kids that come from all around. They come to our free school because of our child sponsorship, and they can come to that free school and get a meal every day. And it's just amazing to see how people in America could sponsor a child, and it, you know, will be used for amazing things, such as like building a school and sustaining that school. And here's where it all started, in just this little two-room horse stable, and you know, God is just so awesome that He's brought people along from America to join up with people here so far. And just to make an awesome school, and to see kids that are so happy to come from miles around to get an education and to just love each other and to learn to love God.
My name's Kenny, and this is my wife Jenny, and we are standing on a mountain in Chauffard, Haiti, which is south of Port-au-Prince, a very remote village. About 5 years ago, we had the opportunity to come here and meet these beautiful people and find out about a school and a church that had just started, and we just decided that we were going to commit to partner with this school and church as they grow and serve the needs of this community. And it's been an amazing ride for 5 years. But I'd say hands down, probably the thing that we're doing that's having the most impact is the free school that we helped to start here that now has over 300 students in it.
About 3 years ago, our school started to grow at such a rapid rate, we realized that to be a free school, we had to have a way to fund it. So we began a sponsorship program, and we started with just 20 students in our program. We got profiles and we got pictures of students here in our school, and we brought them back to the U.S. And we had U.S. citizens who decided they wanted to sponsor. So for $30 a month, people can give, and it goes to our sponsorship program, and it helps to provide the education for 300 students. And for $30 a month, you can pick a child and change the life of that child by adding just financially to the school that is growing and is flourishing.
Yeah, so here's the deal. Nothing spectacular about us. We're just a normal family from the United States. We have four kids of our own and jobs and other things that we do back home. But we found like this was an opportunity that we could do some good in a remote place that nobody knew about. And so a lot of people have jumped on board. They've come on trips, they sponsor kids, they pray for us, they've supported financially some of the bigger projects that we do. So there's 100 ways you could be involved if you want to be. And so just check out the website, get in touch with us, find a way to partner with us. The tagline of our organization is called A Mission for All of Us, and that's because we really do believe that it's not just a select few that should be or get the opportunity to make an impact like this, but really all of us do. It's just who's going to take us up on the invitation to get involved.
This is the clock upon the wall. This is the story of us all. This is the first sound of a newborn child before he starts to crawl. This is the wall. fight's never won. This is a soldier and his girl. This is the mother waiting by the phone, praying for her son. Pictures of you. How hard we might swing. Pictures of you.